You were unsuppressed.
Guys, we've got Broadhog and the Lucy Bros versus Cheers Love. Kitty. Aw, thanks, Pusey.
Thornmallow moved in from the end of time. Chrono Trigger.
Good evening.
You unsuppressed.
Hello. Is your cat talking?
I was trying to make her talk. I was just petting her. She was complaining about it.
Toast was very happy to have me back today.
I bet.
He came galloping out of the other room when I got home. Rooney and Colrath had excellent cats, and they are a very interesting bunch since there's four of them, but none of them are as good as Toast.
Did they ever get accustomed to you?
Well, Rex is, like, just into anything, especially if it's awesome and might get him in trouble. Lucy likes people when there are no other cats around, so I did get her on my lap, especially the last evening when the other cats were distracted. And the kittens were sometimes able to forget that they were afraid of me, and sometimes not.
That's nice. Well, at least they didn't completely reject you.
I made them these origami little toys that I also make for Toast, and they loved those, so at least they've got that.
That's cool.
We also enjoyed watching the other games from there, although we may have been, like, counter-commentating Spectre a bit from the couch.
Yeah. I don't think you were probably as harsh as he was.
Oh, I don't know. It was just, like, Spectre commentary only going on. It was kind of interesting.
Yeah. It was hard to get a word in sometimes. No, I don't want to join Esau's group.
So, fortunately, Zach did at least show me the patch notes earlier today, so I know that some things changed.
Yeah, McCree got an adjustment. I wouldn't call it a nerf. There are nerfs to it, but overall he's a little bit more balanced.
Well, yeah, the fact that he was basically as good as a sniper was maybe a little silly.
Oh, yeah. And it's...
I was enjoying playing him this last week.
Yeah, he's definitely a bit strong in the last game that Cheers Love played.
Definitely was noticing that. I'm a little sad that Wynn never played Zarya during any of the last few, because, well, McCree. Why would you not McCree?
Yeah. So we're missing Jafonius and Mistletoad from Team 1. And I don't know who we're missing from Team 2. Zoroaster. Okay.
How did last night's game go?
Went pretty well. The Persistent Jerks Engineering won Gibraltar, while Amazing Jerks Brigade won Ilios and King's Row. Really strong defense by Persistent Jerks Engineering on a Gibraltar, holding Amazing Jerks Brigade to point A.
Wow, that's impressive.
Yep.
I was super pleased to have Matsushi's team get a point, of course.
Yep, that was good. I would have felt bad if they didn't.
I didn't get to watch last night since I was in a hotel, and I would have been like watching on my phone or something. But
it's kind of cool. Nick put together a overlay for us, which makes it look a lot cleaner.
I see that now that I actually look at it. I was probably up late enough, though I didn't intend to be. The hotel room next to me was full of multiple kids that apparently had a very late bedtime.
That's never gonna be easy.
No, especially since I was hoping to get an early start on the road today, and I still did, but it just with no sleep.
Yep. I'll try and do that a little bit more, Tiggs. We'll try and interrupt so there's less, so there's more awkward conversations, if that's what you want to hear. I can slinking, but the map shows it itself in the middle of the screen when we actually get in there. The scores are just basically text fields that I can update in OBS.
Oh man, Bartholomew's icon is messing up the whole chain there.
Yeah.
Nisoth looks like he must be on the wrong team.
That's true.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, he fixed it.
Gilliam moved in from the end of time, Chrono Trigger, by PDX. Kazanier moved in from the APM channel, SC2, by PDX. You unsuppressed Kazanier. You unsuppressed Gilliam.
Hello.
Good evening.
Evening.
Bartholomew, I thought you did great commentary the other night.
Why, thank you. I will try to be at least as pithy tonight.
I'll try at least to stay awake during the whole thing.
I did get a little bit of glee going back and listening to the match. I think it was Gilliam who said, "Oh, I really don't like this three tank idea," right before we bum rushed them for our only victory.
I mean, I was also calling for two supports, and literally nobody did two supports, and it worked out.
We were sitting on the couch going, "Strat." I don't think that's the word.
I appreciate those opinions. That, like I said, glee.
We only can work from our own experience. We cannot fathom what potential combinations AJB can come up with to define to brute force their way through a competition.
Well, and it's, I mean, I said to the team right after, a substantial amount of it was luck. Like, I just happened to be in the right place to hook wind a couple times in a row, but it could have easily gone a totally different way.
Well, I was very happy you guys did get that point.
Thank you.
So yeah, we're just trying to get a couple people, and locate a few people fill out Team 1, which is the Bro Dogs. Sorry for the delay, everyone. Gilliam, I'm considering swapping you in to give you a chance to just to get the game started.
I guess I'm not opposed. I feel like I'm kind of low on the low end of skill spectrum for that team, but beggars can't be choosers, so it's their fault.
Yeah. I think it'd be fine.
Yeah, sure.
Alright, we'll do that.
Alright, I'll just drop out of Mumble for now.
Sounds good.
We're starting in a moment then?
Yeah, we're gonna get started soon.
Alright, I will be right back then.
All right. Sorry for the delay, everyone. We are going to get started soon on the teams we have tonight. Team one is the Broadhog and the Lucy Bros with Bones Jackson, John McGee, Tay Hax, and those are the only three that are actually of their team. Ramtar, JK, and Bartolomew are all filling in. On team two, we've got Regions team with Wind, Mummer, Teeps, Esoth, and Zoroaster. And that team is Cheers Love. With me tonight is Thornmollo, casting alongside, if she is back.
Hello.
There we go. And we're going to give it a couple more seconds while JK tries to figure out how to get his icon set up correctly.
So we're Broadhog and a few of the Lucy Bros?
Yep. Two of the Lucy Bros.
And off-brand Lucy Bros or something?
Yep.
And Cheers Love the Jerks are actually here?
Yep. We have everyone except for Kayleth tonight. Alright, we're gonna go and get started then.
But the icon.
Yep.
Now arriving at Elias. Prepare to attack.
Alright, and we've got the ruins up first tonight with early picks. Mummer's picking up Roadhog, and Bones Jackson on his Zarya pick.
Wind's staying with McCree, even with the slight changes to him that came through today.
Yeah, it seems alright. We're going to have a Pharah battle between Tay Hax and Esoth. It should be a pretty good
Same
one.
Same standard.
Yeah.
Zoro's on Mercy. This is not terribly surprising. He's been support for most of this tournament.
Yep. See single support for the Broadhogs, the blue team, with Bart on the Lucio, being the Lucy bro tonight.
That's right, and a somewhat exciting Junkrat pickup. We haven't seen a lot of Junkrat, I feel like.
No.
And we have JK and Teeps filling out with soldiers on each team.
Yeah, Romy definitely has a lot of experience with Junkrat. Played quite a bit with him. And we'll see where they get started up. Both these teams are have a good chance to advance in the next round. Should be a good matchup we've got here. Enemy contact. And we see once again that the Broadhogs are playing fairly aggressively, trying to get a couple pickoffs. But Wind is the first to take off Tay Hax, and Teeps takes down JK.
And Wynn gets another one on Ramtar.
That's good.
Teeps gets Bart. All right.
And Zoroaster's playing safely in the back. He might get picked off by Jonald if he's not careful, though. Yes. And Bones goes down.
Red gets first cap. Looks good for holding it for a while.
Yeah, and Wynn's already got his ult up. Tehax picks off both Esoth and the support. And Wynn picks off Jono on Tracer with that, and then another pick off on Rami.
My item is discharging.
On the objective.
JK is getting harassed in the backfield by Wynn, and Bones is the only one on a point right now. Bart did swap to Mercy there, which is going to provide him with that res. Which he'll have up
Thoros
pretty soon.
Res is up.
Heroes never die.
Now. Yep, and for there it's huge.
Looks like he just got teeps with that.
Esoth and Tehax continue dueling in the sky.
I do like that Zoros is trying to support Esoth with a little bit of pharmacy action. And Red's able to hold here.
Take cover.
Quite a few ults available on blue if they can hang together for the next push.
Yeah, Regen backs them off, but I think this is going to allow them to... They might be able to get a pick off here. Well, JK with the ult is able to... Oh, he doesn't get anyone.
Heroes never die.
He does get the Mercy.
Alright, so only Teeps left on point. Should allow blue to cap here.
That was important considering they're up to 97%.
Yeah. 99 before they're able to cap. And Rami throws his tire up. See if he can break it down and get anyone with it. No, it gets picked off by Esoth.
There's High Noon, Whole Hog, and Justice available for Red Team. So they have a good chance of recapping here with nothing available on defense.
Esoth gets picked off during his ult. But he's res with along with Regen there. That was a good res by Zoro. Wynn is probably gonna get Bart. Yeah. And Red's gonna be able to recap here. Securing the
objective. And that looks like that'll close out the first point.
Yeah, they're not gonna be able to get back in time. Jono won't be able to stall long enough. And Mummer zones him out with a good ult there. Alright, so the Cheers Lip team goes up with a quick 1-0 on Helios.
0-1.
And now we're at the lighthouse.
Quit screwing around and get ready to move.
Lucio coming at you!
Remember, well, at least when I'm stuck in the spawn, I can check out whether people have good skins or not for their characters.
Yeah, John Ole, I see, is sporting the soccer mom look with the white Tracer outfit.
Oh, with the gold?
Yeah.
Very important.
Don't see any big swaps here, although Rami does go on to the D.Va here. That'll be interesting to see if he can use it to some effect.
Bart's back on Lucio, and the red team actually has double support, and their tank has gone down. Remember, picked off early, or fallen off? I'm not sure what happened there.
Looks like he fell off the suicide death.
Always strong.
Yep. Blue might be able to cap here. They've zoned out, and they have only two left on point for red. I'm on the objective. And they pick it up, and they should be able to hold here if they can collapse back on the point. They need to pick off Zoroaster, who's sitting over on the back.
Oh.
Esoth has not died this entire round so far.
Surprised Zoro's still alive. He's done a good job dodging and weaving.
Yeah, he's doing a much better job being in good positions tonight than he did the other night.
Get over here and heal up. Near the action, but not in the action. It's very important for Mercy.
Yeah. And Red might cap here. Step right up. Wynn with a zoning ult to keep him off point. And we'll see what we get here. Got you this time. So Bones runs in and he's He's solo. He's probably going to go down if he's not careful. Yep.
Yep. Tayax is pushing the air here.
Blue has really gotten separated from each other here.
Yeah, definitely. They're not playing together right now. And that's, I mean, to some extent, that's just that
they're half
playing
subs,
together.
So that's a little hard.
Yeah.
Yeah, they did well at first, but just now in the past 30 seconds or so.
Move back. Enemy.
Wind holding them back again. Didn't get anybody with that. Lucio, counter ult.
Ooh, nice ox by Tayax, but he gets picked off by Esoth, who counter ults him. And a nice res by Zoroaster, who's gonna get picked off. Mummer with a good ult here.
Yep, and Blue again has to answer this. Nobody has any ults available at the moment. That push wiped them all out.
It's an interesting swap. They've gotten triple tank for the Broadhogs with double... double
Mummer
Winston.
Just jumped off the map again, it looks like.
Yeah, he got knocked off, I think.
Hold up now.
Get back.
Yeah, this is going to be the do or die time for Blue Team. They need to cap here.
Tactical visor activated.
Zoro just got knocked off the map.
I'm claiming this objective.
Step right up.
All right, Wind trying to answer. Let's see if they. Looks like they all found their corners.
Yeah.
Except for Jonald.
Well, Jonald got picked off by Mummer's grip, which allowed him to be in line of sight for that ult.
We're losing the objective. Enemy contact.
Oh, good Zarya ult.
Ooh, and Mummer gets knocked off again. Nice Rami ult there. Got three pickoffs and two knockoffs. Region swaps to a Reaper to get that counter on the two Winstons, so I think it's a good swap there.
Pardon me.
My ultimate is ready.
Esoth comes in solo, which means he could easily get picked off here. He might try and ult the point, but it's going to be tough when he's by himself.
Well, here's more of his team here with him. Oh, yeah. Zoro, he needs help. Oh, Zoro, nobody's going to save him.
Zoro goes down, and Mummer's going to knock. Yeah, he gets a good pick off there on Bart.
Real important. Zoro dying there. Wow.
Yeah, he could have been saved if people had been a little more aware.
Yeah.
Right on target.
Let's break it. Regen tags the point for longer overtime, but it goes so fast now.
Yeah.
Esoth's gonna have to tag it. Oh not
no.
Fast enough.
He ulted instead of getting on the point, that cost him there. So now it's tied up, and that's good. It's tied up 1-1 here. 1-1.
The thing I noticed is the blue team coordinated ults a lot better that time. I mean, the first point we saw Azaria ult with no real follow-up, and they still got the point, but it wasn't as clean as it could have been.
Yeah.
They combined a lot better on this one, and with a couple of extra Zoro deaths, that was it.
Yeah, I mean, once Zoro started getting out of position, it basically meant that they didn't have that support to be able to keep him up or get those solid reses.
The boop off the map there at the end was so sad. It was like, save Mercy!
Yeah. Esoth was right there too. He could have just gone over the edge, lifted him up, and saved him.
Always be aware of your Mercy, people.
And now we're on the map with the most potential for environmental kills. Okay. You see Mummer
already. This is the first hook, yep. We do not have a counter Roadhog this time, which might be the first for this map.
Yep.
You feel that?
I've expressed my distaste for Roadhog in general. I think he's not the greatest and gets overplayed quite a bit in the tournament.
He's very frustrating for lower level players.
Yeah, but you see there, I mean, if you watch him, that battle between Bones and Mummer, every time Mummer would grip, Bones had his shield up. So it was just like, he kept feeding him energy.
Oh, Bart.
No, Bart's going to come out?
Is he gonna get out? Is he going to get out? All right.
No, I think, yeah, look at that. Oh, nice.
Not in a good position. This is not so good. Okay, well, the Zariel kind of saving him there.
Gets a nice pick off on Zoroaster. Zoroaster? What's your perspective on how to pronounce that name?
You got a lot. I just call him Zor.
Zor. I agree with that.
I am ready to activate the sound barrier. Speed boop.
All right, let's see what Red's push can do here. They've got several ults available to him, but Teeps is down right now.
Yeah, unless they can
Save
pick up Rami first.
Save
Rami's dead.
Oh no! Goodness.
Well, three of them down.
Heroes never die.
Four of that new and improved D.Va ult.
Wind gets Bart with his ult, and Red's gonna retake. They're gonna take it here.
Definitely. Although Teeps also burned his ult, though it didn't look like it did too much.
Oh.
They might have been able to save that one for another push.
Mistletoad will be on after Ilios.
What'll be interesting here is to see if Red can hold out against the really full stack vaults Blue has coming up.
Yeah. I like Esau's positioning here. It's nice.
Yeah, that was nice and sneaky.
Yeah. But I think Blue might be able to cap here. They just need to make sure to pick out Zoros there.
We need to defend the objective.
Well, they lost Rami early, and Bart popped his ult pretty early too.
They still pick up a point though.
Yeah, still enough. Oh, and the Zarya ult really.
Ooh.
No, you're not.
That's an interesting counter ult to the Zarya ult.
JK is by himself and gets picked off.
You really usually,
you usually expect a more defensive counter ult to the Zarya ult, not rockets coming at you.
Or that.
I have done that before.
It worked.
Yeah.
It was a really impressive job by those two staying alive and being able to recap after that big flood.
Enemy contact.
Romy's dead for Blue, and that's sad because he had his ult up.
Yeah. He had that ult for 2 minutes now, and they just keep losing him early every time, so he's never in position to use it.
Wow, Wind just keeps charging this ult so quickly.
For a price.
It's still high noon.
Yeah, I didn't realize it swapped to double McCree there.
Oh dear.
Even Wind can't charge ult that fast.
No.
Red is down an awful lot of people. Here's Blue's cap again.
Yeah. They
this
needed
point
it.
Has been back and forth.
Oh! That was nice.
I want to hug you like big fuzzy.
Oh, yes. The voice line from Zarya. I want to hug you like big fuzzy Siberian bear.
My ultimate is charging.
Gotta practice.
Bones is out of position. Gets picked off there by Teeps.
Oh. Yeah, he really didn't need to be either. They were all up.
John picks off Zor.
He didn't have his ult up. Oh, JK gets down the trash chute.
Yeah.
Mummer's been waiting to do that all game.
Yeah, it didn't seem like too much of that had been happening.
Well, he spent so long dueling Bones, and Bones knows better.
My ultimate is charging.
Wind holding them off the point for a second here.
You just gotta find the right target. Ah,
looks
nice.
Like only Wind got caught in Zarya ult, but down he goes.
He got Esau too, and I was able to pick him off.
Yeah, that might be enough.
Yeah. Zor's gonna get picked off if he's not careful. He does. And Teeps is next. Yeah.
Really nice job by Bart saving that ult to sort of seal the deal.
And
here.
I don't think Red's gonna make it back in time. Nope.
So now the Broadhog and the Lucy Bros go up 2-1 on Ilios.
2-1.
Now show them.
Back to the lighthouse.
Your In from the Nether, Minecraft, by PDX. You unsuppressed your hood.
Alright, so we see region swap back to Reaper there, and we're still got double support on the Broadhogs.
No Winston's yet.
Nope. I feel good about the Broadhogs team against the other team.
The other team. Get them. Some healing?
Teox gets a good, quick pickoff on Wynn, which is going to be strong to make him sure that he doesn't build up the ult immediately. Teeps grips and Jonald, and now he's out of mech. But Blue's going to be able to cap pretty quickly here.
Yeah, they lost Zoro early too, which is a big change from how last game went.
Yeah. So now we see him grouping up in the back. They might be able to charge up ults from that backside. But they're going to need to make sure they don't get picked off. Bones and Bart go in with JK. JK's going to get picked off if he's not careful, but he's safe. Teeps isn't able to complete off on that grip. And they're getting back. Yeah, they're getting back capped.
Heads up. Taking the objective. Get over here.
Region almost completely back capped. Yeah, they do.
Nope,
wow.
They get it.
That was a great back cap there. They were so spread up and pushed forward that they didn't miss that someone was on the point.
Yeah, that was an excellent bait and switch.
Alright, we see him coming in the mid. Zor's out of position. If he's not careful, he's gonna get picked off pretty quickly here.
Teeves gets picked off. He came in too far.
Yeah. Oh!
Wow!
Blue's gonna recap here pretty quickly.
Yeah, they only took out two, but it separated the rest of red team.
Yeah.
They're all going one by one.
Rami's gonna get picked off if he doesn't get some protection. He does. Bones is able to shield him and get him off.
He's gonna get hunted down here.
Yeah. Teeves tries to hold the point.
There we go.
Teeps gets a pickoff on JK, but Murmur's out of mech, and Esoth with a decent ult here gets picked up by Jonald.
We're still immune after the res.
Yeah.
For some of that.
Regen did great work staying alive long enough for them to get back, but it wasn't quite enough.
I do like how the Broadhogs have kind of shut down Wynn here. He hasn't been able to really get any good ults since that first or second round.
I'm told that's what We're All Jerks here eventual strategy turned into towards the end there. Kill Wynn.
Oh, did you see that? Bones was able to use that D.Va ult to get fully charged.
Yeah, Zarya can make good use of other people's ultimates often.
Yeah.
Anyone need some healing?
He's at 49 energy right now, so it's pretty good.
Okay, ults from all around here. But Regen got picked off.
Oh, excuse me. Tactical necessity.
Fire at will. Form
up on me. Tactical visor activated.
Heroes never die.
Ooh, nice reser visor.
Enemies re-engaging.
Enemies reviving.
Enemy contact.
Does get picked off by JK. Red might cap here just because they've
Red
got the team.
Yes.
Yeah, extremely impressive way to resist that Zarya ult.
Yeah.
I thought that would seal the deal, but they really recovered.
Alright, well now they've got one or maybe two more good pushes left. And if they
also still have two ults available even after recapping.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Blue only has one, and it's gonna be a struggle for them to get more than really one good push.
Yeah, all their other ult charges are very low.
Jonal is probably going to get his pretty quickly if he can stay alive. Wind is, ooh, he gets a nice pickup on Tejax and Rami.
And Tejax was the only ult available on Blue.
All systems checked out. Clearing the area. Activating self-destruct sequence.
Ooh, nice. They pick up the point. Esoth ult just gets picked off by JK. Now the test to see if they can get back in time. I don't think Zord can. He needed to be there now. He hesitated, and it was just 1 second too late.
Good point.
Yeah, 99-99, and that's gonna tie it up, and this is gonna be the final game of the best of five.
Play of the match.
What?
No, that was
3-1. Oh, that was, 3-1. Yeah, we see there. Wow. Oh! That was a nice knockoff.
So what do you think the teams could do differently to actually hold the point longer and let it be less back and forth?
I don't know. I think they were just doing a really good job of countering there, which made it so they couldn't... we were seeing really good swaps to counter what was going on.
Yeah, I felt like the first lighthouse had more character swaps, but yeah, the ults always felt, you know, pretty answered one-to-one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the red team did a surprisingly good job every time I thought of countering Bones' Zarya ult, and that's really what their team has relied on, is coordinating that well, taking out three or four people, and then mopping up, but they just haven't been able to close the deal on that most of the time.
Alright, so we're going to be heading to King's Row next. And I want to thank JK for filling in on short notice there. It's greatly appreciated.
Alright, look, the team's back to all piggies.
Very important. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see, taking off what you said, Thornmallow, about Wind, at some point during our game last Friday, Wind swapped a soldier because he felt like he wasn't being effective enough on McCree after getting two or three alts shut down, and it'll be really interesting to see if he does that again here at some point and changes characters, or if he feels like he's getting enough mileage out of McCree right now. He definitely got a really good play at the end there, taking out two people, and that was enough for them to make that final push, even though it wasn't ultimately successful.
I feel like McCree's really good at answering Pharah right now. Or was before the little patch that went through. But with everybody seeming to want to play Pharah in this tournament, it's good to have, you know, it's either got to be McCree or Soldier to take down the Pharahs.
Yeah, that's definitely true. They have a couple of people good at playing Soldier on the team also, so I don't think necessarily they'd give that up. They still have either... I think Teeps has been Soldier most of the game when he wasn't Roadhog, and Regen has also done so. So they have a lot of options there. It'll just be interesting to see if Wind changes anything.
I was really interested in one of the earlier King's Rows from last week that I watched. I wasn't doing commentary for. One of the defending teams had none of the spam damage characters on defense, neither Junkrat nor Pharah. And that seemed really odd to me from what I've seen of King's Row. Afraid I don't remember who it was.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. I'm trying to think back about the games I watched.
So we've got Cheers Love down 0-1 to the Broadhog and the Lucy Bros. And gonna make sure both teams are ready. I think they both are.
I also really just like Junkrat, so I like seeing him played.
Yeah, And we have not seen very much Junkrat at all this tournament.
No, we have slept one round this time. A couple people played it last night, but other than that, really, no. Okay, I think... I think both teams are ready, making sure. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and get started. I think we're going into King's Row.
Now entering King's Row.
Quick double support lining up for the defense there with Mercy and a Zenyatta.
I like that pick.
And we've seen regen on Zenyatta before, this will be a lot of fun.
Yeah. See what the red team picks up too. We got early picks with Reaper, which is good, especially if they go with any kind of large tanks. But they go with D.Va.
Aardvarks.
Yeah, Aardvark. Let's see if Aardvark pays off here.
I'll be busy soon enough.
The attack team seeming indecisive a bit here.
See Rami picking up a soldier, that's a good pick. Don't think Jonal has much experience on Pharah, but he might be able to do it if they go with that. But he goes with Lucio instead for that double support.
Let's hear those guns.
So the key here is going to be that Zoroaster needs to make sure that he is not picked off quickly. Mummer's pushed up really far, and as a solo tank, it's pretty dangerous to do. He's got a lot of backline teammates that need him up front, or need him to not be get picked off right away. I do think Teeps is going to need to flank here to make sure that he can get some good pickoffs on the to support for the attacking team. We see Mistletoad going around. He's trying to flank, but he's playing straight up and backs off. Tapes is playing frontline Reaper. I'm not too much of a fan of that. And Tayhax is behind, and he's about to pick off some people if they're not careful. He sees the turret, and maybe he'll be able to get that picked off.
Alright, Missile trying to walk through the room here.
Tayhax is doing some work on the back line right now.
Yeah, it's like they just forgot he was there.
Yeah. He gets picked off, but his team can advance. Regen gets picked off. And Zor's gonna get picked off pretty quickly too. You know, he's 3v, he's out of position.
Heroes never die.
Picks up
Regen.
Yeah,
but the other team didn't seem to pay a lot of attention to him there until after he got Rezo.
Yeah, but he only got Regen up. That's not gonna be the strong. Regen's not close. He's close to ult, but it's not gonna be enough to hold the point. Maybe it will be. We'll see. Yep, Rez's gonna back off. Ooh, nice pick off there by Tayhax in the back line again. Doing real good work with Reaper right there. And Red's going to be able to pick up the point.
Yeah, really good job by Red in being able to hold against a wave of Rezes. They just stuck together, didn't get separated.
Let's see.
Quick time on that.
I'd watch Tayhax here. Look at where he's positioned. Look, and then he's got ult up. He's looking to get a nice, big ult out of the team.
This payload!
He's gonna go after Wind first, and then.
Yeah, well, now Wind has noticed him now, but.
No, hold up.
Alright, back off. I know that this ult's gonna come pretty quickly here. And he's fighting with Teeps in that med pack room. The red's getting a strong push right now.
Experience tranquility.
Good ult by Regen to stop. Teeps us pick off Bones, but
doesn't get much else out of his ult.
Yeah, but they're three support, or they're two support and soldier mismatched here. They back off without being able to get picked off. That's pretty good. Now Teeps is out of position.
It's real interesting that TX hasn't found an opportunity for that all yet.
Yeah, well, I mean, sometimes it's better just to hold it.
He just got picked off by Regen, who also picked up Mistletoad earlier. Zenyatta can jump a lot of damage into people.
Yeah, Regen is particularly good at it.
Well, they gotta know that Regen's behind, and they're not really looking around to see him. He's gonna get a couple good pickoffs here.
Not good.
And he ults to get back to his team. Wynn gets good pickoff on Bart and Rami.
He's doing a really good job, but I sort of feel like the rest of Blue thought that the point
was
wrong.
Alright, Tayhex is looking for his moment here.
Yep, here it comes. Gets one, and Mummer is gonna pick him off with Esau support.
Oh, excuse me.
No, he ran.
He managed to get away, but he really didn't get as much out of that as he was hoping.
He's still out of position, so he could get picked off if, without getting anyone else.
My ultimate is ready.
So 5% HP.
I'm ready to resurrect you.
Should be enough to just get him killed. Blue's gotta be careful about not getting back up here while they chase one Reaper who's very low.
Yeah, while they were all distracted by T-Hex, now Red is gonna be able to cap.
Yeah.
Fire at will.
And now they can't, yeah, that's great. That was a great ult by Bones.
Oh man, yeah.
Mummer gets a Rami, but
yeah, a good delay, but not much else.
I would have saved it once they got a little further in, because once you get to this hallway, there are a little bit less options for being able to zone out.
Right. It seems like it made sense there, except that it's so easy to hide around the corner of the tank that
yeah. They're gonna be able to push this in. Esoth, they will get Bart. He's gonna get picked off now.
His res up too.
Yeah. But they're just not contesting right now. They needed to swap to a Reinhardt here, I think.
Yeah, every time it seems like Blue has a few good kills, the rest of the team isn't there to really hold and capitalize.
Yeah.
Fire at will!
Esau's not gonna be able to solo cap the or solo hold him off. And 3:40 is our time here.
Complete. Yeah, that's a pretty good time.
Switching sides. Score. Seems like we had a number of fights there that happened rather away from the payload. You know, it just kept moving.
Yeah, definitely. Blue felt like they never got really close enough to keep it stopped, even if they were winning and killing people.
Right, the chasing down Tayhex was particularly, you know, non-profitable for them.
Well, especially considering they allocated half their team to do it and failed to kill him. I mean, that's just a mismanagement. Their resources there.
Right, ignoring him's not the right move, but you need someone that can reliably take him out, which is not trivial.
No, but I mean, even if he's in the back line, as long as you're aware of where he's at and can communicate to your team, there's a low Reaper here. You should be able to get one, maybe two people to go chase after him, just so you have a team advantage. But if he's flying around and moving to different spots, that's really tough to be able to not be able to take him down there. It causes way too many issues, and it allowed them to get a good push out of that car.
Yeah, exactly. I'm sure TX feels like it wasn't super effective. He never got a super good ult off. He killed a few people, but in sort of board control terms, it was very important to have him doing that.
And now we see Mistletoad going on Symmetra as their secondary support, and Rami playing some Mei. We'll get through this
just fine. Single support on both teams. Both have a Mercy this time. Two tanks for the attacking team, both Roadhog and Reinhardt.
Yeah.
And wins still on McCree.
Time for a new adventure!
And Esoth and Tayhax are fighting the skies again.
May's giggle is so traumatic to me. I just have a hard time listening to that.
Yeah, her standing there when your characters die just feels real bad.
Just the glare as she lines up the headshot as you're frozen. Just terrifying. Bones can go down pretty quickly.
I love that Zenyatta payload bad cartoon. Payload.
We see Mistletoad's down, but he has the teleporter up once he gets back. And I think he might be able to hold off glue long enough for him to get back and throw it up there.
Ooh, yeah, Esoth. Heroes never die.
Ooh, he's rezzed by Zor. And it's gonna be tough. You can see Mistletoad coming back. He puts the teleporter a little bit further back, but it's enough to be out of position so that if Blue wants to go chase it down, they're gonna have to go pretty far back to get it to it.
Blue is missing an awful lot of people right now. Just about everybody.
Yeah, Tayhax did a lot of work there.
Yeah, they were all up there, but just couldn't get a kill on any one person.
I would like to see a swap up here on the Blue team. Maybe go with
Bones gets hooked and killed.
I'm not sure. Actually, I don't know. I think Widowmaker would have been a much stronger pick than Soldier.
Teeps' ult there seemed early. He was near the point and way away from the opposing team.
He thought more people were going to come out and wanted to zone him out, but it just wasn't worth it.
Good ult there by Vart. And Esoth gets a pick off on Mistletoad.
I think it might be. Right.
And good old Viazor. Woo! That was fantastic.
Very good ult. That's five people dead there.
That was great coordination between Bones and Tayhax.
Yeah, that's what Bones' team has been up to most of the tournament. I'm surprised we didn't see that earlier.
And they only have one charge left on that teleporter, so it's going to be interesting. They won't have. Won't be able to just get right back
and
in.
And it's gone now, so Mistletoad's building towards another one again.
Yep. And Bart goes down, so he's not going to be able to get back quickly. This is the time that they need to capitalize as the Blue team to get back in.
Yeah, Blue
they're
doesn't
already
have
behind
any
health bars, so.
Yeah.
Resistance neutralized.
Mistletoad's down.
Three down for Blue.
Yeah, I feel like they just aren't staying together with their tanks, you know. Let's see if Hammer Down can do any work for him from Murmur.
He's gonna get Jonald probably, but Rami's able to zone him out.
Yeah, the DPS is just not there, and then that ult really.
Looking like a lack of communication happening on that team.
Yeah.
Heroes never die!
Bark gets a res. Is able to keep the defense up. At this point, I think we're pretty much out of time.
They're really almost out of time here.
Yeah. They wouldn't have enough time. This is gonna finish him off there.
Get to cover.
You've tagged it.
Yeah, but this is certainly not going to be enough.
Yeah, time-wise, just stopwatch.
Yeah, basically we had 20 seconds to go the entire distance.
Have we seen many other full holds on the first point?
The last one we saw was the other night, where the Precision Jerks Engineering held Amazing Jerks Brigade to point A.
Helden sterben nicht. Yeah, and earlier, Zarya
never gets the credits for these.
Yeah, the thankless hero.
Earlier we saw, we're all jerks now. I think also by Bones' team, we got held to the second point, also on King's Row. Just got bottled up in that tunnel.
Yeah.
No, sorry, I meant we're all jerks now was the ones getting held in that tunnel.
Yeah, I think I remember watching that.
Yeah.
It was extraordinarily unpleasant.
Alright, so we're going to wait for Esau to get back, and then we'll get started on Watchpoint Gibraltar.
Did anybody try to play Anna last night?
Yeah, I think Wind tried to get it a couple times. So, Ultra, the offensive assist is... Yeah, it's basically boosting her healing.
Teams are back together. Are we ready?
All right, we're gonna go get started here.
Arriving at Watchpoint Gibraltar. Prepare to attack.
So we're going to start with the Broadhogs on attack. And we'll see how Cheerslope sets up their defense.
The characters haven't loaded in for me yet.
They're not yet. Yeah, you have to... Okay. No, it shouldn't start there seeing people populate. Alright, for defense we've got Mummer on Roadhog as their solo tank, Wind back on the McCree, Teeps on the Soldier, double support with Regent and Zor on Mercy and Lucio respectively, and Esau filling out the team on, with no surprise here, Pharah.
Look at those multiple Annas.
Yes. Mother knows best.
It's possible Donald might stay on Anna.
Seems unlikely.
Well, it's high noon somewhere in the world.
Nope.
Do like that Bart pick by Zenyatta. He's got a lot of time played on Zenyatta. That's going to be a very dangerous one for them to pick up here.
Defense is actually all the way back, seeding the first point, it looks like, to the server room.
Yep. I think Mummer will need to swap.
It'll be real interesting to see here how well Wynn does. He's had a lot of luck playing off that server room and being able to move around. But obviously Red Team is focused on taking him out. They feel like he was carrying the blue team.
Form
up on the payload. And Tehex and Teeps are down.
Yeah, I really pick up on Teeps, so it's going to be tough because now they're down. Mummer will go down pretty quickly if he's not careful. Wind gets picked off too. Region's out of position. He's going to get picked off by the red team, the
Soldier,
attackers.
Yes.
Yeah, it didn't look like Red was doing all that great, but they really separated the two halves, the blue and capitalized.
Yeah.
Turn it up!
Remember, just keeps fight. Trying to duel Zarya, and that's not an effective choice for Roadhog.
No. I mean, he really should be going after the support, the attackers, and going after the tanks is just inefficient. They did get a stall here.
Enemy contact. Yeah, he should be focusing on their soldier, their mercy if he can get a shot. They're far. Let's break it. Damn!
And they weren't able to capitalize on that Zarya gravity hole.
No,
maximum charge. He's so good at having that energy so high.
Yeah.
Ooh. It's interesting because T-Hex is there, but he just wasn't putting damage into that gravity ball.
Like that ult, and they're gonna pick up A here. Esoth with a good ult behind.
It didn't get anything.
Yeah.
Well, one person went down, but it sort of scattered them. So yeah. They might be able to buy time here.
Mummer with ult, but he's separated from his team, and he's gonna get picked off. We'll give him a little bit more ult charge. Bones does have another ult available.
Oh, Mummer gets away.
I think I'm kind of wonder if they're just letting him stay alive, so they can keep building that ult off of him.
It was only Bones and T-Hex. They might have not wanted to push up too far without the rest of Red Team.
They
now
do.
They're all back together.
Yeah. And unfortunately, I think Mummer's probably going to stay on the Roadhog here, even though he should swap off so he can get something more defensive than Roadhog. Ooh, good old Bazaar to give him that sound barrier.
That was interesting. A monkey smacked Reaper into the back where he decided to ult. It didn't work out too well for Teeps.
One thing I'm noticing for the Cheers Love team is they're not doing a good job of covering that high ground. So they're always fighting from below.
Yeah, they don't really have anyone who can deal with T-Hex once he's up there, unless Wynn can get a shot.
Yeah.
You know, you have to rely on your Pharaoh being able to get up there and win a duel or something like that, and that's just not going to happen here.
Mummer's going to get picked off here again by the two tanks. And see, Mummer's held that ult since the first A, the A checkpoint. And they're already almost to the final checkpoint. And instead of having used it or zoned him out or killed him and swapped, he's stuck on the Roadhog, which has caused him to not have a very strong.
Wins was pretty good.
Yeah, waiting all game for a good High Noon and we missed it.
I watched it. I just didn't want to talk about it. It's old hat.
We're not allowed to talk about Wynn.
No, it's fine.
Another Zarya.
Oh, nice.
Rez inside it.
That was a decent recovery. They ended up only down Mummer.
Again, Teep's ult to little effect there.
Whoa, Wynn had another ult.
That may have been a fat finger.
No, but they get three there, and they're able to push back.
Yeah, all of a sudden, Wynn is doing a lot of work, where it feels like we haven't seen him for most of these matches.
Yeah.
I don't know what changed.
The payload stopped. Get it moving.
It's probably because I insulted him.
No, it looks like Regen has swapped, and is primarily damage boosting Wynn, so that might be just the change they need.
Yeah.
50% more is a lot.
Yeah, he's building out like crazy here. It's moving.
88, 89. He's probably gonna get the mistletoe to pick off here, and Regen needs to back off. Yeah, he does, and Wynn's got another ult ready to go.
Oh, Regen's in trouble.
And Bart picks him off. Nice pickup by Bart.
Very lucky. Good job.
Tayax does swap to Reinhardt there, and that's new.
A little too late on Bart.
Yeah, but they get the res on him anyway. And let's see what they can do. Whew! Nice!
Yeah, don't think Wind will be able to build well. Let's see, we might get a great high noon here.
Zorth, a good sound barrier there to keep his team in the on the payload, but it's gonna get pushed in unless it can get to that back there. Yeah,
no, it's just not quite enough.
3:32 on the time.
Complete. Score 0-4. Switching sides.
Alright, so they've got. So I'll give them. It's 2 minutes per checkpoint, I believe. So. And they have to get there by 3:32. That's gonna be. I think it's gonna be kind of tough. They had a bit of defense on that A checkpoint, which is the big gate, Hangar 18.
We're going all Genji and Hanzo, apparently. Oh no, maybe we're going all Anna.
We're all Anna now.
We're all Nana now.
At least Regen's team wants the stream to be entertained.
Yep.
May you have Bart's play? Symmetra, are we surprised?
What's your secret? No, not at all. I'm not sure if I'd recommend it. I don't think they're gonna lock in this comp with the double Anna and the Hanzo. If not, this is gonna be a glorious, glorious match.
So this is interesting. Load's team looks like they're gonna try and defend the first point.
Yeah.
We've got Missile Hode and Tayhax, so throwing out lots of splash damage. Team currently looks fairly fragile, so that could be good.
Well, it's gonna be interesting. We'll see what happens. I don't think this is...
Okay, now we have a Mei instead of the second Anna. Yeah. Really?
No Anna at all. Oh wait, no, we do have an Anna. Region gets picked up.
This
one has- we do see Bart's almost two-thirds of the way to a teleporter.
The Wind is building out really fast, but I wonder who he's going to turbo.
Probably Teeps.
I suppose.
Oh no, he swaps off to actual sniper.
Well, that three sniper comp is definitely what I go for when I want to push a point.
Yep.
Mistletoe is doing good at throwing damage there, but he got chased down by Murmur.
Well, Bard's gonna have. He has teleporter now. That's basically
and,
gonna be it.
Yep. Choose up the unsuited D.Va.
The enemy has a teleporter.
No! Till Valhalla. You hear that? Okay, now we have the attacking Torbjorn. Naturally.
I would have gone with Bastion.
Here comes a Riptire.
Nope. It's gonna. Nope. Nope. Maybe. Oh.
Yep. Yeah. It ate Torbjorn.
Regen with the.
That was a little bit. Okay.
And Rami is gonna get a couple pickoffs here.
Well, yeah. Bedtime. Sorry, alt enemy, alt.
Oh, but Rami's asleep. Hi, Rami. Wake up.
They possess a teleporter.
What is even going on here?
I think they're just trying to have some fun here.
Oh, here comes the Bastion.
Yeah, this is an acceptable choice here.
Are we supposed to call him El Presidente? I don't know why.
Well, El Presidente is only if they've got a Secret Service Reinhardt.
Ah, I see. They've got Mercy, but that didn't save.
Yeah, they need the Reinhardt there.
Who needs tanks where they're going, apparently?
Yeah.
They should just make a robot collective and all play Zenyatta.
Shield matrix established.
I have secured the
monastery.
Payload. Let's move.
Oh, the payload moving. No?
No.
Ever so briefly.
Look at that. Look at that. Whole feet.
The wolf marks his prey.
All blue team is alive, though, isn't it?
Yeah, but with 340.
There is the teleporter.
The way is closed. No one could hide from the hunters.
Look at that. Bastion just escorting it.
Do not let up. Victory will
soon be ours.
I have low
moving the payload. Falling behind. Sniper, be ready! Time is
running. Wait, Tobin, what's wrong with Panic at the Disco? Alright, now it's gonna be game. Alright, so... Roadhog again, the Lucy Bros go out 3-0, cheers love. Which puts them into first place.
It's high noon.
Alright, so Cheers Love is still tied in for third place with the Precision Jerks Engineering. And they, Precision Jerks Engineering does hold the tiebreaker between the two of them. Broadhog and the Lucy Bros have one game remaining against the Amazing Jerks Brigade, which should determine who will be the top team going into the round of three. We have the Precision Jerks Engineering and the We're All Jerks facing up will be one of the next games, and those two games will close out the round robin. And thank you, Kaz and Thormal, for casting tonight. I appreciate the help.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you again.
And that's going to be it for tonight. Thanks so much for watching.